Jonathan, yes. One, two, yeah. John.
Well, we gotta rehearse because we suck.
Two, yeah. John. Yeah.
Well, I hate rehearsals myself. I think it sucks. I like to rehearse like 2 days when we go in to do the production rehearsals. That's when you start getting serious, and then when we play the shows, it starts getting serious.
Jonathan, one, two, two, yeah. Two, yeah. Jonathan, one, two, two, yeah.
A lot of these songs we haven't played for, years.
I was a mess. I was hitting wrong pedals. I messed up probably 50-60% of the songs.
I think it re-educates us in how to play our instruments. It's been so long since we played, we kind of have to relearn how to play pretty much. So it gets us ready for the tour, so we can go out there and hopefully not stuck for the first 3 weeks of tour before we get it together.
We gotta get, we gotta get our act together. We don't even know the songs. I had to listen to the CDs, figure out the songs. That's what it's about. Not all together, we'll do it on the way to rehearsal, and we'll listen to the CD, and that part, and you're trying to think in your head, okay, where's that on the fretboard? Where are those notes at? And then you kind of, you get here, and it comes fast. Play it in an arena and on a stage, it's going to change, because we're not in a tight, closed room. We're going to hear it bounce back, I've seen David hit the snare, and then I'm hearing two snares because it's bouncing back from the wall behind it. Once we see our stage, our production, everything just falls into place, then we start to get serious and go, oh, okay, it's time to stop fucking around. Definitely felt the progression in rehearsal and our performance.
We've done it for so long, it just... A couple of weeks of rehearsing in the studio brings it back.
We're gonna get together and we're trying out. The tour is kind of sucky because there's problems, they're gonna bug out at the show and stuff like that, but
playing wise, it's some of the awesomest shows.
I got three costume changes actually, but the third one's in here yet, so everything goes in here. I get changed and I get dressed underneath the stage, and it's just massive chaos.
Yeah.
I'm still nervous, I'm still on record now.
I mean, you see us at practice, we're just standing there playing the songs, but we're on stage, we freak out because the fans make us freak.
It's just feed off the crowd. That's what really keeps us all going. I could never get on a treadmill and run for an hour and a half, but I could play for 2 hours on the stage.
Of the set, lights come on, and John's like, "What the hell?" to everybody, and you see people like, they're like ants, and they're like,
it does pump me when I see the crowd going crazy. Around a sound that we found when we were experimenting. We like, oh, we take that sound and maybe those two or three notes that we discovered the sound with and base a song around it. And then we can't come up with, like, he'll discover a really cool sound with in combination with a riff, and you know, I'll put something to it that makes it sound better, or you know, or I mean,
not that it sound bad to begin with.
But he was always a better player than me.
Yeah,
he still is
better.
Too.
I was a lot better than him. Like, I still am like a lot better.
I do the rhythm thing, he does the melody.
Power Oasis. Is that?
Hey, come here.
Billy! They're from Bill.
They're homeboy right here.
Oh, Billy. Man, Jesus. Oh, I was looking for you guys right now. Robert, I found him. God, bring the whole boss in.
Let's just kind of look around with this.
Yeah.
Oh, roll. Go ahead, roll tape.
Yeah. Looks like an electric guitar.
Mm-hmm.
Look
at how big it is.
Right there. Look at a drum set for Fieldy right there. Man down. Might be Happy Days for some reason. This is the old, Do you know guitar? This is from Ronnie James Dio. I think they have a guitar just like this, actually. Except it was...
Well, yeah, like that, right?
Yeah, it was more
then he
star.
Sold it to me and ripped me off.
That was it.
You ripped me off.
They know the story.
Yeah, I know the real story.
Which one?
Oh, the thing with the RPM on it? That just came in, huh?
If you, yeah.
Bass on the steering wheel. Listen to music and I keep hitting the steering wheel. And then that, between that and not building that helped a little.
Hey, what's up? This is Head from Corn. And you're watching Cornography.
Hey kids, what's up? You're watching Cornography. We've got some questions we pulled off the net. And we'll try to give the best answers we can. Rob Lee from San Luis Obispo wants to know what our most embarrassing moment has been on stage while we were playing, guys.
I threw up one time and fell in it. I slipped in my own puke once. That's my most embarrassing
one moment. One time we were playing this little club, thank God it was only a little club, and I'd been partying a bit too much, and I went on the complete wrong part of the song, and everyone stopped and turned and looked at me.
That's the worst.
That little college town,
we were playing Faggot.
Yeah.
And we're all, oops.
One time I was playing, we were on tour with Ozzy, and and I jumped off the monitor, my feet flew up under me, face first, and the whole arena stood up, and it was like, yeah!
Broke his face in half.
Face broke and shit, I was embarrassed.
Yeah. Turn red right now.
Shit. What do you got, you mean?
I would love to, Anastasia, but I'm busy. Got a tour.
I mean, look around. Some of the art's so sick and twisted. It's just like, damn.
I'm a good girl. I don't do anything bad. The sick and twisted thing I've ever done is date him.
What's the most sick and twisted thing I've ever... Oh, no, I can't say that. No, no, if my mom is home, no. No, I don't think so.
It's falling away from me. It's falling away from me. Less falling away from me.